Amid the scorched plains of the Ice Age, as cold winds swept down from eternal ice sheets and herds of mammoths thundered across the trembling earth, a creature emerged from the shadows with innate majesty and ruthless force. Smilodon, also known as the saber-toothed cat. Unlike any big cat still alive today, Smilodon was the embodiment of a perfect blend of beauty, lethality, and ancient mystery. The name saber-toothed cat is not an exaggeration. Its two upper canines, reaching up to 28 centimeters in length, resembled curved swords protruding from its mouth, creating a terrifying and unmistakable image. But Smilodon impressed not just by appearance. It was one of the apex predators of the Pleistocene, living in harsh ecosystems where survival was a constant battle. Smilodon was not an ancestor of modern lions or leopards. It belonged to an entirely separate branch of the feline family, having evolved independently for millions of years. There are three known Smilodon species, with the most famous being Smilodon fatalis, which roamed across North and South America. Weighing between 160 and 280 kilograms, with a short, muscular body, broad shoulders, and exceptionally strong forelimbs, Smilodon was no plains runner like the cheetah, but an ambush predator, a close combat assassin. Imagine a gloomy afternoon on the ancient steppe. Faint rays of sunlight pierce the thick clouds, and a herd of ground sloths grazes peacefully, unaware of the cold eyes watching from the bushes. Smilodon crouches low, muscles coiled like drawn bowstrings. It doesn't growl, doesn't move, just waits. When the moment comes, it lunges like a living blade. Front claws sink into the prey's shoulders, bringing it down with overwhelming strength. Then the head retracts, jaws drop, and the saber teeth drive deep into the throat. It all happens in seconds. Silence returns, except for the panting breath and the smell of blood. A question that has puzzled scientists for centuries. Weren't such long canines too fragile? In truth, Smilodon didn't kill by tearing flesh like a lion, but with a precise bite to the throat, targeting the windpipe or arteries. The saber teeth weren't for pulling, they were for stabbing. Its skull had a special notch in the lower jaw, allowing it to open its mouth up to 120 degrees, wider than any known cat, so the long canines could penetrate without obstruction. Moreover, Smilodon's neck and shoulder muscles were extraordinarily developed. Fossil skeletons reveal unusually tall vertebral spines in the neck, evidence of massive muscles capable of generating bite force far greater than that of African lions. This made it a biologically optimized warrior for top-down attacks. But the greatest mystery doesn't lie in its teeth. It lies in the La Brea tar pits in California. Over 2,000 Smilodon skeletons have been found there, along with the remains of prey species like horses, bison, prehistoric camels, and even baby mammoths. Why did so many saber-toothed cats fall into this trap? One intriguing theory: Smilodon may have lived in groups. When a prey animal became trapped in tar, it likely cried out, and the first Smilodon pounced, only to get stuck. But the strange part is, not just one, but dozens of Smilodon individuals were found trapped nearby. Did they come to fight over the carcass? Or did they come to rescue a packmate? If the theory that Smilodon lived in social groups is true, it would overturn the long-standing belief that big cats are solitary. It may have been more like wolves, cooperative hunters, territory sharers, even caregivers to injured members. In some skeletons, scientists found healed fractures, meaning the individual survived for months without being able to hunt, possibly due to help from its group. This becomes even more fascinating when placing Smilodon in the Pleistocene ecosystem, a wild world where every day was a battle. Beyond their prey, they competed with other predators like the dire wolf, a wolf twice the size of modern ones, the short-faced bear Arctotis, which stood up to 3.5 meters tall, and the most dangerous of all, humans. The emergence of Homo sapiens brought an ecological revolution. Armed with spears, javelins, traps, and cooperative strategies, humans became super predators. They not only hunted efficiently, they competed with smilodon, stole carcasses, seized territories, and completely changed the rules of the game. One tale depicted in cave paintings in South America shows an ancient human drawing of a saber-toothed cat marked with wounds on its chest and a human holding a spear nearby. Could this be a memory of a real encounter? A smilodon wounded by weapons? Or proof that humans didn't just fear these cats, but once fought them head-on? Smilodon, evolved for cold environments and large prey, couldn't adapt quickly when the climate warmed and large herbivores disappeared. Grasslands gave way to forests, where there was no open space for ambush. Prey became smaller, faster, and more scarce. Heavy predators like smilodon were gradually pushed to the ecological margins. Around 10,000 years ago, they vanished, without fanfare, making way for a new era in which Homo sapiens became the dominant force. So, if smilodon were still alive today, what would its fate be? Could a cat with saber-like teeth and a bulky body survive in the Amazon rainforest? Or would it be hunted down and caged in wildlife parks? Maybe they'd be cloned in a lab, like some current de-extinction projects in the US and South Korea. Scientists have extracted DNA from the tooth pulp of smilodon fossils, but high fragmentation and lack of complete samples have made its revival more distant than that of the woolly mammoth. Still, if one day technology advances far enough, should we bring smilodon back? Would it be a symbol of rebirth or a warning of what should not be repeated? Regardless, smilodon's traces remain. In cave art, stone carvings, the DNA of modern cats, and in our imagination. It wasn't merely a cat with long teeth. It was a symbol of dangerous beauty, of elegance and brutality, and of an age when nature had not yet been tamed by humans. Imagine, if smilodon lived today, how would it survive? In a zoo? Or stalking the shadows in Canadian forests? Could it coexist with humanity? Or would it once again be driven to extinction by the consequences we bring? Smilodon was not just an extinct animal. It is a reminder that evolution does not guarantee survival. That perfection for one era can mean obsolescence in the next. And that deep within the predatory instincts of modern cats, there remains a voice from the past. The roar of a warrior long buried in tar, waiting to be remembered. Thank you for joining us in tracing the journey of the saber-toothed cat. If you believe this is a story worth telling, please share the video, subscribe to the channel, and leave a comment below. History is not just what is past, it's what continues to be written every single day.